Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at 10 tricks for selecting text on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So you probably already know the basics of selecting text on your Mac. You can click anywhere and drag and select characters of text. My first tip is that you could double click to select a word. So for instance, if I wanted to select this word right here, I just double click and it selects the entire word. I don't have to mess with selecting before the first character and dragging to exactly the end of the last character. But in addition to that, if you triple click, it will select the entire paragraph. So three clicks like that selects everything here on that paragraph or line. Now you can still drag after doing the double click or triple click. So I can double click on a word here and after the second click I'm still holding down. And now I can start dragging and it's going to select by word. And I can go as far as I want in the document to select just by word. I can even go and select previous words as well. The same thing works with triple click. So I can triple click here, continue holding down after the third click, and now I can select by paragraph. Now if you'd rather use the keyboard, you can do that by indicating that you want to make a selection by holding down the shift key. If I just move the left and right arrow keys, you can see it just moves the cursor. But if I hold the shift key down and move, it will select as I move using the arrows. Now you can modify this by holding the option key as well. That selects by word. So if I put the cursor at the beginning of a word there, I hold the shift key down to indicate that I want to select something. And I hold the option key down to indicate that I want to select by word. Now I can use the right arrow to select by word. I can also do it with the left arrow. And the same thing works with the up or down arrow. So shift and then option and then down arrow goes to the end of this paragraph and every down arrow after that will continue to select more paragraphs. And I could do the same thing with up arrow. Now command plus left and right arrow will go to the beginning or end of a line. Not the paragraph but the actual line of text. So if you hold the shift key down and then command, then you can select everything from the current position to the beginning of the line. Likewise, shift command right arrow will select to the end of the line. And there's an unusual combination of these. If you use shift command left arrow and then right arrow, you get the entire line. Now if you do the same thing with up or down, it goes to the beginning or end of the document. So I can shift command up arrow is everything from the cursor position to the beginning of the document. And shift command down arrow will select everything to the end of the document. So if you've been typing and you decide not to use the last couple paragraphs and go back to say here, you can do shift command down arrow and then a quick delete to delete the end of your document. Now you can also use the shift key to select a range. So I can put the cursor here and then before I click anywhere else I can hold the shift key down and it will select that entire range from the text cursor position to the point that I clicked. The same thing works going backwards. I can select here and then shift click here to select everything from this character to that character. Now I've been demonstrating using this in text edit, but all of the things I've shown so far will work in other places where you select text. So they'll work in pages for instance or mail when you're composing a message. But these next two tips will only work in text edit. They don't work in pages, they don't work in mail, they don't really work in other apps at all. But you could always copy text, paste it into text edit, use this technique, and then copy and paste it back. So the first is you can select a rectangular area of text by holding the option key down. So with the option key down I will click here and drag and you can see how it selects characters in a rectangle. This is really bizarre especially if you're going to hit delete there and it's going to delete all of that stuff. Now if you hold the option key down and double click then drag it will do a rectangular area but selecting complete words. Now here's an example of where that could be useful. Say you have a table like this. It's just a text document with tabs. And you want to select just some of the columns, like maybe just the first four columns here. You can hold the option key down, click and drag and just select these columns. And then you could copy that and in a new document you can paste those in. Now here's another one that only works in text edit and that's to be able to select non-contiguous portions of text. So you can do this by using the command key. So I'll select some text here. Then I'll hold the Command key down and select some other text. And you can see both pieces of text are selected. I can continue to do that and select all sorts of pieces of text. And you could do things like this, like make them all bold or a certain style. You can copy these. And you can see if I go to a new document, it pastes them all in. It keeps the paragraphs there, so each one separated into its own paragraph. Or I can simply hit delete to delete this selection. So I can kind of select a few things that I think I might want to delete, think about it for a second, and then hit delete to get rid of them all. So the last trick I want to show you is the simplest. And most Mac users know this, but some don't. And some people know it but forget that it's kind of there. And that's to simply use Command A to select all. And you can always see that under Edit, and there's usually Select All Command A in just about any app. And this is really handy to be able to quickly select all of the text and copy and paste that into another document. Maybe this is just a portion of some text that you're writing and you want to quickly copy it from this little document into a bigger one. Command A and Command C will quickly select all and copy, or Command A and Delete will clear out a document. And here's a bonus one. You can select some text and you can do a search based on that text. If you look under Edit and then Find, there's usually a command for Use Selection for Find. Command E is the default shortcut for that. And this is there in TextEdit, it's there in Pages, it's there in Mail. And if I select that, nothing seems to happen because it basically uses this selection for the search and it's just showing you the first one. But if I do Command G for Find Next, you could see it quickly finds the next one there. So I can select some text, do Command E, Command G to find each one after that. So there's a look at some tricks you can use when you're selecting text. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.